Tumutan niya, and to obey the scout law. 12 other people at all times to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. I addressed it to all the Boy Scouts, and the Girl Scouts, and the young people. Follow the law. Follow the truth. Now, Mr. President, every president takes his oath. Every senator takes his oath. Every congressman, every mayor, councillor, police, barangay captain, they take their oath. If we do not take that oath seriously, ano klase tayong tao? That's why I keep my oath in my box. Napagbawalan ako ng argument, sometimes hihilahin ko yan, sabihin ko, we took an oath. Ayan ang mga oaths natin, no? We keep our oaths in our rooms. It's for decoration. We have no culture of oath-taking in this country. It's like we pray every day. We pray for guidance. We pray for justice. Mr. President, kayo na sumagot. Tayo na sumagot. I'm not trying to be holier than thou. A Filipino soldier takes his oath. He will not be cowardly. He will serve the country. A policeman will take his oath to protect and to serve. We all take our oaths. That is the history of oaths. That is why when somebody takes an oath here and violates it, Republic Act under the Revised Penal Code, Article 183, punishes somebody who lies under oath. Ayan, false testimony in other cases. Mababa pa nga ang penalty. Dapat siguro taasan na yan eh. Arresto mayor lang yan. Now, Mr. President, ilan yan? 1 month and 1 day to 6 months. That's why siguro hindi masyadong pinapatulan yan. Okay lang. Huwag na tayo mag-oath. Okay lang. We can forget our oath. We forget it. Tomorrow, they'll forget it. Now, Mr. President, if that's the way we want to raise our children, our country, then we'll say oath becomes cheap. So, Mr. President, when Arthur Las Cañas became a policeman, he took an oath. When he says he's not, when he answered upon the question of the senator that brought her, ikaw bang head ng DDS? And he said, no. Dapat nagalit si Senator Lima. Nagsinungaling sa kanya yung kanyang testigo eh. But he says, when he says, the DDS is just media hype, that the DDS does not exist. He had nothing to do with the mosque bombing, October 3, 2016. My goodness, Mr. President. Now he says, he bombed them. And you want to believe this man? This man who lies frequently, who claims he's paid to murder, he is paid now to talk? Can I ask that question? No, I will not ask that question. I'm sure I will say, you are now paid. That's why you're here. And I don't think you can blame me if I said that. Ako lang ho yun. Wag na iba. He was a person that come and lied. And lied again. He lied to his family. He lied to his fellow policemen. He lied to his community. He lied to this country. And we want to honor him now. Bringing him back here. Let's take it to its logical extreme, Mr. President. He now says, I'm telling the truth. Ito ang napapatay dyan. Ano gagawin natin ngayon? Dali natin sa ombudsman, dali natin sa... I'm sure the first question is, are you telling the truth now? Let's take it to its logical extreme. Hindi ba dadali sa impeachment yan? At pagdating sa impeachment yan, ano mangyayari? Aabot ba yan? We're giving our country false hopes. That is why I was so careful. My statement in the recommendation I made, we find no evidence in this hearing of that this is sponsored by the state. You can mock me, you can do everything you want, but that is the truth. There was no evidence presented that showed this. Now, if this man said, eto, meron, then meron tayong pag-uusapan. Eh, hindi niya ginawa eh. Hindi niya ginawa. So, Mr. President, I'm not here to convince you. I'm not here to say, oh, huwag na tayo tawagin yan. Nasa sa inyo na yan, kanya-kanya na yan. But I personally would like to take this off my chest. My wife told me, wag na dik, kaya mo na. My wife was having a high blood episode yesterday. That's why I had to go out. I was really. And when I came over, wag na, sabi niya, wag na natin patuloy niyan, dik. Let us pick our battles. Pick our battles. Mr. President. What battle is that? Hindi ba, it's a battle against ourselves. Hindi ba, it's a battle that when you're called to stand up, you have to say so. You have to stand up and speak for the truth, even if you're going to hurt your party, even if you're going to hurt your friends. You stand up and say, I cannot agree with you. Now, Mr. President, that is me. I am not going to impose it upon anybody. But take time. Tarry a little before we proceed. The next time we invite somebody here, let us make sure we read his oath 20 times. Let him promise 20 times. Because nobody's going to respect us here. Ay, Senado, madali magsinuwala yan, papatawarin ka. Magpe-press conference pa doon sa Senado mismo. Ano mangyayari sa investigasyon natin? Ano mangyayari sa mga tao na pumupunta rito para humarap ng katarungan? Which sometimes we ourselves cannot even do. You know, Mr. President, I wanted to deliver a speech the other day. A UP student, a UP businessman, o sabihin ko, a fraternity brother, was killed in Batangas, murdered in Santo Tomas, Batangas. I wanted to speak, pero ang dami. So what am I going to do? Andun ho yun sa recommendation namin doon sa Committee on Justice. Anytime there's a murder, you count it, and every month, how many people have been killed in Batangas? And it is reported to the Committee on Justice and Peace and Order and Public Order, and we call Bato or General De La Rosa, and we call the Provincial Director of Batangas and say, 200 deaths in your area, and you're not doing anything about it. Perhaps it's time to change the PNP. Perhaps it's time to change the budget. That isn't the recommendation. Every province, para matigil unti-unti, you cannot slay extrajudicial killing. I was still in the previous Senate when I spoke to a senator from Vermont who accosted a senator when I was lobbying for the veterans bill that we got eventually. And he was saying, we cannot give you any money. There's extrajudicial killing. That was how many years ago, Mr. President? More than 10 years ago. Now, Mr. President, you slay it by saying, ay, iyas, hindi ka na pwedeng umiwas. You have 15 days to finish that report. And you report it to us right away. And I'm saying, hindi na pwedeng kabaro ang mag-iimbestiga ng pulis. Ang pulis ang mag-iimbestiga ang husgado. Dapat mabilis. Mr. President, unbeknownst to you, for the last 3 weeks, I've been sitting down with plebs trying to figure a way how we can spend that 100 million so that we could have plebs all over the country, in the Metro Manila area. Para the people can go to plebs and say, sinaktan ako ng pulisyan, pinatay ako ng pulisyan, and plebs, motu proprio, within 60 days, can say, you're out of the police. You're suspended. And while you're suspended, you cannot, when you appeal, you have no gun, you have no shield. That's the solution, Mr. President. Hindi yung magsisisihan tayo, na kumakampi tayo, na partisan tayo dito. You cannot solve that. My father's case has not been terminated. The masterminds remain free, and so does a thousands, maybe tens of thousands of others. And now this, a police officer comes in. Hindi ako sinampal, Mr. President. Ang sinampal tayo. If you don't feel that, maybe I'm right. Maybe I will have a hard time crying to get back into the Senate. So, Mr. President, It means a little bit of nobility. We disagree with one another here. You know, we always try, let us be noble at least. Let us try to treat each other with respect and candor so we can find out the truth. Not our anger, but the truth. So, Mr. President, on that note, I have said my piece, and you may judge me. If you want to question me, you may do so. But as far as I'm concerned, I'd like to apologize to my wife because I'm sure she will be very, very stressed. But I cannot do that. She's not feeling very well. And I said, I'm sorry. I have to follow my conscience and my heart. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Gordon. Majority Leader.
Senator Cayetano wishes to seek the floor, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Cayetano, recognized.
President, First of all, may I just salute my colleague, Senator Gordon, and give him a hug.
Lights.
Mr. President, may I just state for the record so we can diffuse the atmosphere, he's not my type, but because he's a senator, I'm willing to be hugged.
No. I know this is a very emotional issue for everyone, and at stake here, Mr. President, is not just the integrity of the Senate. There is obviously a group in the Philippines that want the Senate to be a part of the removal of the President. There is also groups who want to protect the President, and there are, I assume, 24 senators who does not care about removing or keeping the President there but cares about the truth. And I think that is the speech of the gentleman from Olongapo, no? Who served long and dignified, and I've disagreed with him a lot of times. I've been in that podium and he's been here, but it has always been decent. It has always been in accordance with the rules and the traditions of the Senate. So let me just make this point, Mr. President. I was looking at the journal. So Senator Trillanes moved that it be privileged speech be referred to the Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs. In the onset and in appearance, parang walang problema doon. But alam naman po natin, and during his conference, he said that he will have a manifestation to reopen. So alam na natin na pag sinabing reopen, yung committee na meron original jurisdiction, yun ang magre-reopen. That has been the Senate tradition. That is in our rules. In fact, when a speech has been given, a resolution has been filed, a bill has been filed, there are several here who have been majority leaders, Senator Soto, myself, of course, Senate President Rilon was Senate President for a long time. Senator Meigs, Senator Kiko here was a majority leader. Once it is given to that committee, the only way to release that from the committee is to get a signatures of, if I'm not mistaken, 1/5 of the committee, five committee members, no? Five committee members. I stand corrected. So this did not happen here, and it might have been oversight. But I could see that Senator Soto was sensitive enough in his manifestation to say, okay, since there are no objections because he has to follow the plenary, we will give it to the Committee on Public Order, but we will inform the Committee on Justice and Human Rights because the issue is related to the report the committee came up with. In fact, that was a very polite way of saying it because it's not only related. It is basically the same thing. The Las Cañas or the speech of Senator Trillanes goes into exactly what the Committee on Justice and Public Order was investigating. So, dun po sa mga baguhan sa Senate at sa mga kababayan natin nakikinig, bakit ginamit ni Senator Dick yung sinampal siya dito? Because po, never natin ginagawa dito sa Senado na alisin ang jurisdiction sa committee mo. And never natin pinagbobotohan yon. I'm sorry, I might not have the moral ascendancy to speak about it that much because I wasn't here yesterday. I was meeting some guests, some diplomats, and some foreign investors. But the situation now is we have to ask ourselves, do we want to throw the rule book into the wastebasket? Do we want to take away the traditions of the Senate, na kung sino chairman, siya magdi-decide. I haven't made up my mind whether or not we should hear it again or not. Part of me wants na, sige, papendin natin kasi kasinungalingan naman yun, magigiba naman yung kanyang testimony. But the other part of me is, yung sinabi ni Senator Dick, ba't natin aksayan ng panahon natin? Yung OFWs, yung pensioners, yung senior citizens, you know, some people here keep pointing to the ombudsman. Dapat yung ombudsman. So, why not let Las Cañas go to the ombudsman and do his job? That's what I'm weighing, no? But, I return to the basic principle. We respect the chair. And my chair in the Committee on Justice, that's why it's called our committee. It is not Dick Gordon's committee. It is our Justice Committee. But he is our chair. So why not allow him to make the decision? Now, it's up to you, my dear colleagues, today to make that decision. But if you decide to overrule Senator Dick, I will be here more often, and that is a threat. And why will I be here more often? Because there are a lot of bills that I want to take up. One of them is the ERD, Emergency Response Department. Because ang daming nasusunugan, ang daming binabagyo, and hindi ko tingin na kaya ng NDRRMC, and that is with Senator Trillanes. He has a counterpart bill, so hindi ko naman sasabihin na hindi niya gusto ito. But kung ganyan mangyayari, edi araw-araw, 24 tayong tatayo dito na mag-speech at mag-motion na yung committee na yon, ito i-take up. And then magkukukus tayo. Eh bakit pa tayo magkukomitee system dito? Buwagin na natin lahat ng committee. Committee on the whole na tayo parate. Mag-decide na lang tayo dito araw-araw through caucus kung ano uunahin ng Senate. Or, we can go back to the traditions of the Senate, which is, we talk to the chair and we allow the chair to decide. If we do not have faith in our chairman, let us be honest enough, have the integrity enough, have the courage enough to go up to him and say, Senator Dick, we do not have confidence in you. But wag natin pong sampalin. Kasi hindi natin ginagawa sa Senado yon. Hindi ko tingin na yun ang intention. And to be fair to Senator Soto, our Majority Leader, ang balita ko, ilang tao na lang nasa floor, wala naman pong nag-object, and I see his wisdom in putting it here. We will inform the Committee on Justice. So now we have heard Senator Dick. I have heard him loud and clear. If he is now saying, I will hear it, I will support him. If he is now saying, I will not hear it, I will support him. Because I have faith and confidence in him. Now may I hear from my colleagues here, do you have faith and confidence in our chairman of the Committee on Justice? Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Mr. President.
Just a point of clarification, Mr. President. I did not say sampalin sa akin. Ang nagsabi po niya na si Senator Lacson. It's not personal to me. And I thank Senator Lacson for thinking in that fashion because you may take it that way, but I don't take it that way. I rise and fall on what I do. And I would not think that my colleagues will deliberately, euphemistically slap me in the face. And I'm sure they will be courageous enough to say, I do not agree with this. But a lot of us signed that report, and it's there. And again, I reiterate that we should really act on that. And if you don't want to act on that, I will understand. Senator DeLong said the other day, there is newly discovered evidence. Newly discovered evidence has to be studied. And if this is newly discovered evidence from the same source, it has become a polluted source. Because he has lied. Going out in public, invoking God, invoking everybody in public, he's lied. He admitted to it. Mahina nga Secretary of Justice eh. Dapat perjury na yan eh. By the way, I took the case of perjury to Mr. Bulante when I was Blue Ribbon. Unfortunately, the Department of Justice did not move. And that is the problem, Mr. President. We must make decisions. I am able to stand up here. I am not afraid of the opprobrium that I may suffer from all the trolls. I don't make my decision based on trolls or based on what people say. It is just me and my conscience. And if I fail, it is me. I will not blame others that I made the wrong decision. I will only take it upon myself to say, and be man enough to say, I made the wrong decision. But, Mr. President, the fact that I'm here says that I cannot sit quietly by and allow what I call madness, if I may. The stampede, the herd, the popular appeal, the flashes of new lawyers coming in. My gosh, Mr. President, I am called to make that decision. I've already made mine. And if it is going to be referred to me, I will not hear this man. I will recommend to him and advise him Go to the ombudsman. You have lawyers. Go there. Because hindi ka na namin papaniwalaan dito eh. Ako, at least I speak for myself. I will not believe him. Now, unless there's new evidence, fine. Then, the Senate, in its rightful duty, can refer it again to whatever committee they may see fit. And so far as I'm concerned, Mr. President, from day one, I said, go to court. You miss your chance. You miss the boat. You have a privilege to come here. Nobody poked a gun at you. We listened to you intently. You even went against Matubato. And now this. So, Mr. President, I will leave it at that. I just wanted to unburden myself here. I don't want to bear any ill will upon my peers here. I'm in the last quarter, if you will, of my life, and that's being ambitious. I've seen many, many days here in the past. I've seen the rise and fall of leaders. I've seen our country sometimes go up and then go down. Turn another route instead of going to development and progress. Mr. President, I'm not going to change. I'm not ready to change. I will always stand up if I feel I need to stand up. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Majority Leader.
Mr. President, there are many options.